Moolash!
Stop it!
You're watching Two Brains. This brain is Marlon.
This brain is Liv.
And today we have the new album.
Pegasus coming.
From Trippie Redd.
Pegasus.
This is very exciting. I mean, it's very long.
Doesn't matter. Very long. Trippie. He's the only one who can get away with it.
So it's 26 songs.
An hour and 14 minutes. Holy hell.
It's going to buckle up. It's going to be a long one.
Holy shit.
I'm very excited though.
It's Trippie.
And he gets better and better, in my opinion.
My most rinsed artist of the last 2 years, probably.
Yeah. So I'm hoping this is going to be in his bag. I feel like he's finding his
bag. He's got so many different bags though.
But I feel like he's leaning more into the melodic singing.
Nah, think about how different Sleepy Hollow was to I Got You.
Is Sleepy Hollow on this
one? No, that's a different song.
Oh, yeah,
really? Yeah, think about how different the Bus Ram tune was to Sleepy Hollow.
Yeah,
to Excitement. They're all, every single has been completely different. So we don't know. Dreamer, which isn't on this, that was like a rock tune.
Right,
so it's going to be eclectic. It's going to be all over the place.
Do you think?
Which is what I want. You don't want an album this long, which is just the same thing over and over again.
Yeah, I suppose so. I love the cover. I know a lot of people don't like the cover, but I maintain I love it. I think it's beautiful.
I prefer not to speak.
Okay, so let's get into it. So Let It Out featuring...
Maya Linné. Don't know who that is.
No, me neither. Okay, let's go.
Come on, boy. Come on, Trip.
I try to laugh at the past. Where's all love? But your heart has been absent. You gotta let it out. I know it's kinda hard to give it.
Feels like I'm floating. Do you know what I mean?
It's beautiful.
Her voice is like a fucking pillow.
It's not just her voice though, the whole production is really beautiful.
Think I might let it out. I know it's kinda hard.
This is so
R&B. I know it's hard to get out. You gotta let it out. It's very R&B, yeah.
Isn't it? So much R&B, more R&B than I've really heard him before.
Yeah.
This is a full R&B album.
You know it won't be.
I forgot it's going to do this thing where it feeds into a new song, right? So the song technically is going to start at the end of the previous song.
What?
Right, that's what it did in like Sleepy Hollow and whatever the other one was.
I mean, we don't know because we hadn't heard it in the context of the album.
It just changed though and it's coming to the end of the song.
It might just be a beat switch.
No, yeah, with like 10 seconds
switch.
To go.
It's a mini beat switch.
Right. See?
It is feeding into the next one.
See, it's going to do it in every single one. Shut up. That was beautiful. I'm very
serene.
Relaxed now.
Spotlight, moonlight.
I don't think it's going to have that energy.
Moonlight.
I'ma just kiss some plans. Bend the open hand. I can still be your man. I just want to be with you. I just want to be with you.
Tell me what you're looking for. Similar
waiting
melody.
For.
Is it waiting for?
Yeah.
It's a similar melody.
Similar melody, yeah.
Under the moonlight. Under the moonlight, baby.
Under the moonlight.
Shawty wanna come and have sex with me.
Sex with me!
I just wanna be with you. Under the moonlight.
You know what?
Under the moonlight, baby.
Stop.
Yeah.
Trippie is one of the most romantic artists.
Yeah, he's...
I think I know. He's just, like, so romantic.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
I reckon he'd be like, he'd be full on to be in a relationship with, but I bet he's like loving it.
Under the moonlight! Stop it! Under the moonlight, babe!
Oh, it didn't go to do the next one. Ooh, so this is Love Scars 4.
Love Scars 4. And Love Scars 3 is the best Trippie Redd song ever made.
In your opinion?
In my humble opinion.
Mm-hmm.
And all the Love Scars are fire.
All of the Love Scars are fire. Alright. So, yes.
Better be fire.
Yes.
Don't do it.
You're wrong when you say that this album's going to be really eclectic.
I think it will be.
I don't think it will, because what, this is the
it's only the third song. No, there's 23 more songs.
When you say it like that. No, but like, it's all like very similar instruments.
Yeah,
very
I think it's going to be
sounds,
in structures. It's going to it's going to transform into something
else.
Do you
think?
Yeah.
Okay. Makes a Love Scars song a Love Scars song?
Because they're always heartbreaking.
You're just describing every single
Trippie Redd song. Love Scars specifically. Right.
So it's the themes of the lyrics, is that what ties them together?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Right, so this is
the nether.
Oh.
That beat is fucking amazing.
It's minimal, isn't it?
It's amazing.
Really minimal. So who did most of the... Obviously, he has the producers that he works with a lot. So this
is Oz! That's why it's amazing!
Ozzy,
bounce it. Sorry, yeah, Ozzy. Like, yeah. Some of my favourite tribute tunes are produced by Ozzy.
Oh, right, okay. But obviously he works with Pierre a lot, but it's, like, this doesn't sound
He works with quite a few people, but Ozzy on Love Letter 2 3, which is my favourite tribute product, went ridiculous on that.
This is very minimal. It's a minimal beat, but it is beautiful. I think you happened in my past life. Exit turns was really scary to me last night. I'm blowing dope, it's too much smoke, and I ain't got nowhere to ask, right? I spit my feelings to a glass mic. That boy gets too much cheese. How you expecting that? What did you say? I spit my feelings in a glass mic.
A glass mic?
Yeah. All I can think of is like a crack pipe being glass. No. What else is glass?
I don't know.
Different bitch, a different day. Oh, a bong. A bong.
A bong.
There's both sounds here now, right?
Yeah.
Or is it just us?
We've got both now.
Oh, it's like jungle noises.
Okay. That was amazing. And we hit our first amazing one.
He was kind of rapping.
Yeah, can you rap like me? Yeah.
Not that kind of rapping, though. Okay, so this is So Stressed featuring Young LB.
Don't know. Young left back.
Stop. What the tears from your eyes, I know you stress. What the tears from your eyes, girl, you a bliss. Me, you gon' survive, I love a that melodic line is so good, it's so catchy.
It's Trippie, it's Red.
Like, he's so good, that is his like best thing.
That's his best attribute. I feel like he could just be in a room. And someone would be like, make up a melody. And be like, Shawty, do not play no games with me. Yeah!
So good at it. Me and you can do anything. Me and you. need to stop singing along when you haven't even heard it yet.
Because the minute he drops one vocal line, it's in your fucking head.
I want to hear Trippie. Yeah, I heard it. I ain't the type to stretch it. Headlet bands and strap on the dresser. Got your pussy all wet, getting necked out. Tuck down in 6x6. He doesn't sound very young. He sounds like Busta Rhymes.
He does a bit. He sounds like Busta Rhymes.
He's got age a very in his gruff voice. Yeah. We can travel overseas, bring a friend up to. Let me get charged up like a Pikachu. We can get EVs and EP to two. Let's ride, let's ride in the coupe. I got a case of the hand to see in 42. This sounds a bit like a bit country, doesn't it? I got a case of the hand. It sounds like that. A tiny bit. Me and you can do anything.
Me and you can do anything. Me and you and Hennessy. Yeah.
Okay, I really like that. I thought that was great.
So this was the first single that dropped.
Right, it was a while ago.
Yeah, it was a while ago. It dropped like during the height of lockdown.
Right, yeah. But this song's definitely grown on me.
Has it?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't do like it. It was one of the few Trippie songs that I just didn't fuck with.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, well, it's grown on me, so yeah. I do like it. So it's Excitement featuring Party Next Door. Should we just do a tiny bit and then go on to the next one? But you get me so excited. Okay. I mean, we're not really fans of Party Next Door, really, are we? Nah. So. Okay, so this is
Mood
featuring Chris Brown.
With Chris Breezy. Waves don't die.
I like that the only Chris Brown thing you can think of is not his song.
No, Poppin'.
What's that? Brand new whip just hopped in.
No, this is from like 15 years ago.
Okay. Why are you acting mad for? Did everything you asked for? Blaming me is so unfair. Living is a dance floor. Everywhere.
I don't know, but yeah.
But this is what it is. Yeah, that's the word it
lines. It's an interpolation.
Right.
Yeah. How I've been holding up, blowing
up. So, is it Sleepy Hollow next?
No.
That was definitely a horse, though, wasn't it?
It was a Pegasus.
Pegasus.
There was only a bit of Trippie on that song.
Yeah, I know.
There was only a bit, yeah.
Yeah.
I fucked with the instrumental, I really fucked with it. I like that.
Okay.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
This is
title track.
Pegasus. Yeah. Yeah. She said that she gon' ride, call her Pegasus. Is this him? Bitch, I'm with the guy.
Is it him?
No, that sounds like, what's his name? I can't place who I think it sounds
like. Roddy Ricch.
No, but it's who's the other guy who sounds a bit like Roddy Ricch?
I think it is him. I think it's his voice been pitched.
No.
I think it must be.
He doesn't sound like him. Tryna fuck a friend aside, dig in a crevices. I can't get over this because
it doesn't sound like him.
It doesn't sound like Trippie. And we've heard a lot of Trippie. Yeah. He's made a lot of music.
It doesn't sound like him, no.
Never heard him like this. That's mad. Baby, I'm the one, not the two,
Ably gone. This is sick. This is sick. Because he's singing, but he's also spitting the bars.
Mm.
But it's slow, but he's also like, it's also hard, but it's a slow track.
I get what
it's
you
both.
Mean.
It's the best of both worlds. I bless the hoes, but I ain't name dropping a messy bitch. No, we're going to switch up the sound now, watch.
Do you think?
That's the moment where it switches.
I mean, that was sick.
That was sick.
But I think I need to get over the shock
that,
of him sounding like that, because I can't get over that. So as soon as I'm over that, I'll probably rinse that song a bit.
Trying to fuck in a side digger crevices.
Okay. So this is...
Whee!
I'm a big dog, who you wanna be? Diamonds on my wrist and on my
Stop it, I wanna hear the trees. It.
Can I do the fucking dance like me for
Spit in!
He
said, I'm the king, you Timon and Pumbaa today.
Tease the word, I might become a tutor today. She won't fuck, I might tutor and booter today. Call her ugly, I'll think her from Hooters today.
Sounds like Mr. Poopy Butthole. That was sick.
Okay, that was really sick. I'm really liking all these, like, trippy, no pun intended, like trippy, spacey kind of thing.
Yeah.
It's really cool, isn't it?
I mean, he's literally in space on the album cover.
Mm. Right, so this is personal favorite featuring
Rich the Kid.
Rich the Kid. I love how as soon as I say, oh, I like all these trippy, spacey sounds,
you go,
yeah, exactly. Now it's like, this is much more recognizable,
yeah.
Trippy.
She wanna have sex, let's give it a take. I'm gripping in that wall, I'm rubbing her breasts. You got the throne, you set the tone. And every time she call my phone, you know I'm gone. You deserve it, girl.
Oh.
Girl.
Oh, abrupt ending. Okay, cool. Yeah, that was more like original Trippie.
Yeah.
It's a Trippie we're used to hearing. Nice, so this is B12. Really nice piano.
10, 3,
oh.
Ignition sequence start. Look down. Maybe I'll sound like a girlfriend over my side.
There's a lot going on,
but it's like soft but hard.
Yeah, for sure. But it's a lot. Okay. So this is
Spaceships. With Tugga!
Featuring Young Thug.
I'm fucking this bitch and she giving me head.
I didn't know he was going to be on this album, to be honest.
I'm fucking this bitch and she giving me head. He was just the last tune. He did that tune that went, I'm fucking his bitch and she giving me head.
That wasn't very good.
I like that song.
Okay. This is
Spaceships.
Baby, you can twinkle in my phone. And I'm all loving back home. I swear I don't feel it. It could get real way.
This is hitting different.
Hitting different. Yeah, different.
Produced by ATL Jacob.
I just flew two bitches in from overseas. They both from Portugal, they both Portuguese.
No shit!
We aiming up on the neck, you best move accordingly. We got this shit on lock.
As if he forgot.
What?
Like, forever, ever.
Forever, ever.
That's like one of my favorite Trippie songs, and you forgot that, and instead, you remembered that terrible deluxe one.
In me head.
Fuck's sake. Yeah, they're a good combo,
yeah.
For sure.
That's because my mind be racing,
yeah. I guarantee you, Young Thug is going to pick up that flow at the start of his verse.
Do you think?
Yeah.
That's because my mind be racing. Africa bungee jumping off a thin rope. Keep it real, I want to have some sex on the boat. Pushing me inside you, when you say, hey, yo. She say, I can't wait to leave here with you if you die. I don't want to be no one near when you cry. I swear I don't feel it. It can get real. And drop
is so beautiful. Oh my god.
Yeah.
Good.
Straight into the next tune as well.
That was my favourite so far. That was beautiful.
It?
Yeah,
that was pretty good.
I loved it. Okay, this is Never Change featuring Future. Sorry?
It's produced by Molly. Oh.
What are you saying?
It's produced by Marley. Mar.
There's a lot of producers
here.
Yeah,
secretly, yeah. Everything is good, oh. I'm holding on the words left for my
soul. Like, if someone played you this, like, literally the first 30 seconds right now,
yeah,
would you ever guess that this was a Trippie song?
No, because I can't, no. Because it's Future.
No, but like even the beat doesn't sound like there's nothing about it that makes me think of Trippie. Do you know what I mean?
Kind of.
This beat is doing the most.
This beat is, I mean, there's like seven people,
yeah,
on the beat, so.
I can see why now, but it's amazing. Just me, got no time to fucking play around. I'm a real wings, I go up and then I'm coming down. And no matter where I go, you can never ever change me. Damn,
that's pretty
that was
good.
An epic song, wasn't it?
Pretty good.
I feel like I need to see the stems of that beat so I can see what's going on. Wow. Okay, this is
good morning. Yeah. What the fuck going on? This song is already amazing. It's already one of the best ones.
What's this sample?
I don't know.
Is that sample?
Because I think
like,
so.
No one's listed as a feature or anything.
But this is already amazing.
Okay. Baby, what you really waiting for? I can give you everything you want. My baby, get it this morning. Yeah, my baby, get it this morning. Now he sounds like
Playboy
Carti, doesn't he? Yeah. He does, right? Can
yeah,
I have a conversation?
Sorry. Yeah. Yeah, no, I agree.
Yeah.
He does, yeah.
Is his high voice, is he being the lady?
I don't believe so.
Are you sure?
Yeah, because he just said he was going to beat up the pussy.
What?
Yeah.
Did he say that in the high voice or the lower voice?
In the high voice. He's had a high voice for the whole song.
No, he hasn't. He's going between the two. How did you know it was going to go backwards?
The beat had been backwards for like 30 seconds already.
Oh, I didn't notice.
You need to listen. That one was sick.
Yeah, you liked it?
Yeah.
It was very interesting.
This is so, honourable mention.
No honourable mention.
Oh, sorry. No honourable mention with Quavo and Lil Mosey.
Interesting.
Too bad, bitches, you know what I say, so. Yeah. Rest in peace, rest in peace, rest in peace, rest in peace. Yeah. I hope you need that.
Who's this?
That's Trippie Redd.
Why can I hear Quavo already and he's not even come in yet? Who wanna die today? That's Quavo, isn't it? Quavo Flow.
I keep the steel by the door of the kitchen. Murder right up to the top of the ceiling. I got the love for the rest and they skinny.
This beat's really beautiful, actually. It's doing.
This is produced by DJ on the Beat Source, Topanga. That guy, the guy who produced Topanga.
What, Chop Squad DJ?
Well, I heard the tag at the start of the beat.
What, Chop Squad DJ?
DJ on the beat, so it's a banger. Sorry, is that real? Sorry, I just saw Lil Moses' real name. His name is Moses Lathan Stanley Eccles.
It's kind of similar to Michael Lamar White II, isn't it?
Yeah.
And don't forget Quavo's real name.
Why is Quavo not listed as a songwriter?
Quavius.
Why was he not listed as a songwriter?
Maybe he didn't write his verse, I don't know.
I carry my pipes, yeah. Glitch stuck in my driver's, yeah. Sour killers and rocks, so who think they can stop me? When I touch my first meal, you know how I feel.
Do you rate Lil Mosey?
Not really.
No, I think he's terrible.
Oh, that goes straight into...
Oh, right, yeah, because of the plucky guitar.
That song could have done with neither of the features.
Oh, so you didn't rate Quavo either?
Quavo? No, I don't think that. I did like...
I liked Quavo, I just like didn't like the features. Okay, fair enough. Right, so this is... We've reacted to this already.
Yeah, I got you. Am I thinking of the right song? I'm thinking of the fucking Ari Lennox song, aren't I?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
You know, baby, if you give it
to me, I give it to you.
Right, so we've reacted to this, so just do a little bit.
Yeah.
No cap. A little on attitude. Feeling for you every day. Pulling on my mind, I'm insane. Baby, if you give it to me, I'll give it to you. You know it, I got you.
Right.
Show me if you give it to me. Yay!
Okay. So this is
Too Fly. Because he's on a Pegasus.
Mm. Pussy, nigga.
Yeah, nigga.
Maybach with the curtains and it's perfect like my mama, yeah. I just pulled a fruit in my soda pop.
He sounds a bit like Future. Dude, Too Fly. That, like, that thing is soda pop.
Why are you? Who's over there?
Future.
Hey, look at my eye twitching.
Why is he talking about perks and stuff? I swear he said he wasn't going to take pills. He said, we ain't doing that no more.
Yeah, but this might have been written before that. This album has been floating around for ages, like before even A Love Letter to You 4 dropped.
Okay. I just want him to be safe and healthy. You know, there are really, like, really subtle, beautiful things going on with this beat. You hear there's, like, a really, like... voice in the background, like very distant sounding. It's really cool. Produced by Hammered Beats. Hammered? Haven't heard. Haven't heard.
She like, oh my god, she wanna blow my cot. I'm trying to hit up the spot. Hey. Can't believe I'm hot. She's like, 100
foot beast. She wants to slap. Huh? You want to slap? Slap.
How can she slap?
Okay,
this is the really interesting one.
Or the interesting feature.
It's Red Beam featuring Sean Kingston.
Sean Kingston.
Yeah.
Has Sean Kingston brought anything
out recently? I don't know.
I haven't heard Sean Kingston since my childhood.
Sean Kingston's like the same age as Young Thug.
Is he?
Yeah. When Beautiful Girls dropped, he was young. He was like 17 or 16.
Wow, okay. Okay, so this is Red Beam.
Yeah.
Fair, this is the only song so far that sounded a bit like Halloween-y, apart from mostly Sleepy Hollow.
Yeah.
Going places you can't go, red beam like Kano, we run like a volcano.
Again, he did the same thing as Denzel Curry.
Did you hear that? How it kicked in. Oh my god.
He did the same bar as Denzel
like
Curry.
Almost finished. Yeah, he's a Kano, I heard. Did he use exactly the same bar?
Well, obviously Denzel went, read that to a nigga, I like Kano. And he just did it in a more relaxed.
I mean, this is called Red Beam.
Red Beam.
Yeah.
Why does it fit so well? Why does Sean Kingston and Trippie Redd fit so well?
Oh my god, the song.
Why is Sean Kingston? It's Oz. How do you say Oz? If it's Oz on the beat,
it's amazing.
It's amazing. But it's only 2 minutes and 7 seconds.
I know.
But that's just like Love Scars 3. It's only like 2 minutes and 7 seconds.
Sean Kingston sounds good, doesn't he?
JR! Sean Kingston! Pegasus like Django. Ozzy!
Okay.
Sean Kingston has the best one. Feature on the album.
That was the one.
That was sick.
Amazing. Okay, this is...
Oom's Revenge Oom's 2.
What's Oom's Revenge?
That's it. You don't remember Oom's Revenge from Life's a Trip?
Life's a Trip, okay.
And he has the tattoo on his face, Oom's Revenge. That's his brother.
Oh, right. Okay. Yeah. Okay. So this is part 2. Yeah. Is it going to have the same beat, maybe?
Nah. Doubt it.
Okay.
Free love, free zoo. Yeah, on a mission again. 100 racks, my fingers itching again. I'm big dog, yeah, I'm Clifford again.
What was the line before that? Before I'm big dog. Oh no, that's just the bar.
I'm big dog, I'm big Clifford again. That nigga used to fucking scare me, I'm not gonna lie.
Clifford the big dog.
Yeah, why is he red? Why is he red?
Why is he big?
Exactly.
Like Mortal Kombat, baby, we gon' finish him.
Finish him!
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Pour that shit up. All right, see the homie, man. That disrespectful shit.
Okay. So how's it? I can't remember the first one. Is it similar to that in any way?
Yeah, it's short as well.
Is it just a theme that's kind of the same? Okay. This is take one.
It sounds like Oz.
Jumping the gun a bit there.
Oh, it's Nick Mira. Oh, okay, it's gonna be sick.
Who's that?
He produced he was like Juice WRLD's go-to producer, and he's produced with Trippie as well, loads.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, you ain't one till you take one. Take one, catch me still.
Pipe or a flute or what?
This is the best song on the album.
What are you talking about?
It's the best song on the album.
We've heard 28 seconds.
It's the best song on the album.
You're really showing off your dead trim here.
Sorry. It's the best song on the album.
Did you just hear the pan flute?
I just heard the way... It's the best song on the album.
Okay, alright. They gon' catch me still and shimmin' on my tick-song. I'm a free man, baby, like a Mason.
Are you telling me this is not the best song?
I really liked that one before.
But this one is...
And the one with Thug.
This one is so...
It's a good one.
It's a good one.
It's a take one good one.
It's a good one.
Yeah. You ain't one till you take one. You ain't gonna catch me still and shimmering on my take
some. Oh, you're singing.
The best one. Damn. The best one on the album.
That was really...
That was
really
amazing.
That was amazing, yeah. Okay, so we've reacted to this one already.
Yes.
Sleepy Hollow.
Yes, which is also a banger. Did you want to be so it's a banger?
Yeah, it's a banger.
Play a bit.
Yeah. Feel like Ichigo, nigga, I'm a hollow. Downloading game, get some hot lows. Mercy and I go.
Okay.
I'm ducking, ducking, ducking.
See, like we've already almost heard like...
See the couple shells!
Okay. So the next one is...
Kid That Kid. With Future again and Doughboy.
Hmm.
Future's on it again,
Future's
you know?
On twice.
Yeah.
Didn't notice that.
We pull up in your city, man, like what that mini, man. Double cups and double semis, man, about the move, man. Take a
don't walk, bitch, we step. Fuck that talking, bitch, we wreck. Why do you come to see this? This is such a strange
beat. It's so angry.
Yeah, who's the producer? Oh, DJ on the Beast was the banger.
And CB Beats.
CB Beats. CB Beats. All this cash that's gonna make the nigga surf on white. So I got a bad
bitch at the grill. We like Whitney. I got a man. I get active on the grill. What's the effect on his voice?
I don't know. It sounds like it hasn't been recorded properly. Do you know what I mean? Like, it sounds like he recorded it just like in his living room.
Or like on his phone.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
Oh, it's not, to me, it just sounds like there's a heavy like, effect on it.
Oh, it just sounds like it hasn't been mastered.
Ooh, okay. I really live in shit, I really be. Thanks to sliding minivans, huh? He's not on beat.
You think he's not on beat? No, he's just, you know, he's rapping around the beat.
Alright. Top of six now. People in your city, man, like what I mean, man. You fucking finished, kid.
CB on the beat. That sounded like Buzz Lightyear powering down.
Ooh. Okay. That was
strange.
That one wasn't for me.
It was a bit hectic, isn't it?
But it was like, it was angry. And I'm not an angry person. I like to chill.
You like Sleepy Hollow?
It's not. No, I wouldn't say Sleepy Hollow is angry. That, like, I like hype things. I don't like angry things. I like, you know what I mean? Things. I know you do because you're an angsty boy.
I'm not angsty.
But yeah, a bit too angry for me. So this is
Don. Sippin' down, sippin' down, Perrier, baby, I'm gone, go infinity every night.
Couple real ones with me when I was in a motherfucking drought. You know what, I've never heard Trippie so influenced by Future before.
I mean?
Feel like there's been a few songs where I've heard the Future influence and I haven't really detected that before. You might disagree with me, but that's, I do. 200 on the road, that's my little nigga, yeah, man, you're saying that you don't hear Future influence here?
Not really.
Oh, okay.
There's a storm coming, Mr. Wayne.
My tears gone cold, I'm wondering why.
Okay, so this makes sense. This was
Hell Rain with Lil Wayne and Hoodie Baby.
Hoodie Baby.
I don't know.
Who's that? Hoodie Baby.
Don't know.
Yeah. There's only three songs left, yeah, you know. This album hasn't dragged at all. Relaxing.
Yeah. It seems like I've been scrolling
out. This beat kind of sounds a little bit like the original Oscars, doesn't it?
It doesn't.
Okay, it doesn't matter. And just the way it kicked in was completely different.
Produced by Trippie Redd?
There you go.
I don't know if I believe that.
What do you mean? You don't believe that he produced this? That's so rude, you know.
No, that is rude, but, you know, it's just out of the blue. I didn't even know he produced.
At all?
No. Did you? I've never seen him on a production credit.
Oh, maybe he is Lent then. That's impressive.
He sounds far away. He sounds like he's in the next room.
I do believe that he produced this. It's quite a simple beat.
Fair play.
So he's learning.
Yeah.
That's great. Ooh, it's chill for Wayne. Don't you think that Trippie must be like so hyped that he got his hero Lil Wayne on a beat that he produced himself? I think that's fucking cool.
But Lil Wayne's got those bloody like meditative, like I'm single. It's literally like the most soothing, woozy kind of track.
Yeah.
He's literally like, yeah, I'm single. Yeah, I'm tripping on that. Who's it been? I was that.
Yeah.
Like, he's done that shit before.
Oh.
It's choshed and screwed.
This rain is so relaxing. I feel like I'm gonna fall asleep. Okay.
Yeah, buddy.
Right, so this one leaked, did it?
This one, so I've heard this ages ago.
Right, okay.
I heard it on SoundCloud. Because there was loads that leaked.
Right.
So this one's relatively old, but I remember it being fucking sick.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right, who's it produced by again?
I don't know.
Oh, I thought you knew.
Oh, Scott Storch, yeah. Scott Storch.
Avedon.
Show me, yeah, Scott Storch. It's Scott Storch, is that
right? Right, so it's TR666.
With Sway Lee.
Featuring Sway Lee.
Yeah. This, okay. Yeah, this...
So is it going to come back to you?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, okay. It will come back to me. Okay. Yeah.
No weapon that is against you shall prosper.
Yeah.
We all got love down and go. Third eye open, never close.
It sounds again, tell me what you're wishing for. It's again.
Scott Storch is ridiculous. Do you know why he's so sick? He used to be, he was originally a keyboardist in The Roots.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Mm. And he produced for like Beyonce and shit.
Mm, yeah. Cool.
I love it when she falls. Yeah, I'm on another dose. I float in the truck like a kite. The timing is right.
That's high.
That's what Sway Lee does.
That's really high.
Sway Lee can go that high.
He can go that high without any.
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
I'm so glad that song's on streaming now.
The strings. I mean, it was a good song, but I feel like it's not the strongest.
You'll never know.
But I do feel like there's, his melodic stuff was kind of rehashings of old trippy melodic lines.
It's fucking fire.
That's when it just made me keep on thinking of other songs.
It's fucking fire, mate.
Alright.
You never know, no. We're on the last song, aren't we?
Yes, this is the last song.
Sun God. Crazy. With the woman that was on the first one.
Exactly, so maybe. Maya Lan. Maybe it like feeds into the first one, maybe?
Maybe.
It makes it bigger. It's
ripple. When I'm away just to love you. And baby, I like the sun too. That's why for me, no, I'm sad.
She has such a beautiful voice, doesn't she?
It's a bit angelic still.
It's beautiful, like a backing vocal is beautiful. Yeah.
It's kind of like, remember Koi, where it was just the guitar and his voice and some background?
A little bit. This is a bit more layered though, I would
say.
Yeah,
yeah.
This is like a... It's very like ambient, isn't it? It's very... Yeah.
Serene.
Beautiful. Do you think it feels in? Damn, it's like the sound of its wings taking off.
No.
No, not really. Okay, that was beautiful. I have got to hand it to Trippie. He made an album that's 26 songs long. Without a trash song in there at all. In my opinion, they were all good.
I would say maybe 3 or 4 exceptions.
You think that they're trash though?
Not trash, but
they're just not your
just below like, average.
For Trippie. I disagree. I don't think.
But
that...
even three or four out of 26.
I disagree. This is what I'm saying. I think that's a massive achievement to make a 26 song. Album where there's not a dud in there. For me personally, there wasn't.
I think the biggest dud was the Quavo and Lil Mosey song.
Okay, I still liked it as a song though.
I will never go back to that song.
Okay,
but it's trippy.
I just thought it was beautiful, and I really like the direction he kind of took with it. That all the more kind of like ethereal stuff, the spacey stuff. I wasn't expecting that at all. Were you?
And, I mean, no, like, it wasn't. There was more of that than I was expecting. I was expecting some of that.
Right, more
than I was expecting.
Yeah. It was it all sounded quite fresh and new. There were a couple of songs that didn't sound so fresh and new, but mm-hmm. most of it did. I really liked it.
I mean, Trippie Redd, isn't it?
Yeah. I think there's definitely, I'll listen through a few more times and then I'll be able to pick out one of my favourites.
That, what was it called? Take One?
Take One was amazing.
Ridiculous.
I loved the one with Thug in as well.
What, Spaceships?
Spaceships, yeah. So some of the ones at the beginning. Yeah, I thought it was great. I loved it.
We have it pretty good.
My expectations were high as well. They exceeded. Okay, that's what we thought. Let us know what you think of the album down below.
Make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the bell.
And we'll see you next time.
Bye.